Hey everybody, it's Brandon the Weekend Cruiser, where I go on a weekend cruise just about every weekend, and this time I am staying in one of my favorite staterooms. It is Royal Caribbean's Freedom of the Seas Junior Suite 9344, and it is a hump balcony, and so I'll show you what that means. The first thing it's going to mean is it's going to come with a little bit more space that we're going to get into, but it is a beautiful balcony, a little bit bigger. It is right by the midship elevator, so very convenient to get to. You're going to have a little bit of noise in the hallway from that, but still, overall, it is a fantastic room and probably one of my favorites on the ship. Let's take a look. So as I mentioned, the room 9344 is right here by the elevator. So that little alcove right there is going to be how easy it is to get to your room. And you can see that the hallway does arch a little bit here, letting you know that it is one of the hump balconies. So when you walk in, it looks like a traditional junior suite. So it has a little bit of extra space over there on the other side, but even though it is a hump balcony, it's about the same size as the others, with maybe a foot or two more of space. But if you look over to the left, you're gonna start out with your different cabinets, your vanity or makeup section. So I'll show you where the safe is. My little guy here's fallen off and I can't figure out how to keep him back on, but the safe still works perfectly. Great storage in here, nice and deep. And you're gonna have storage beside of each of the mirrors. So this is one place that I know I've told you all, I like to store these little knickknacks that I get in. I'm not sure if Royal winds up reusing these each cruise or not. The paper or the stock feels a little bit nicer. So that's traditionally why I do like to keep those. You're gonna have your tissues always in the first drawer there to your left, and really good extra drawer storage space as well. If you're looking for your room service menu, that is gonna come here in the middle console. One of my favorite places to store things, and I don't know if others do this or not, but it's on the ledge up here. So I really like putting my glasses there, smaller items. It all fits really well and it gets it up off the desk, so I feel like it is out of the way. You're gonna have two main plugs over here. So you've got two 120 volt US plugs and the light switch for your vanity mirror. If you do want to buy an additional charger, I'll link down below. We have European connections in here too. So if you bring a converter, you can have a third outlet altogether. You also come with the Lavazza coffee machine. So one of my favorite things in the room is the coffee machine. So I do use this often. You'll see I've got the cord hanging over there from where I had plugged it in. This isn't a great location. I've been in some rooms where you have to move this entire station, but this works really, really well. You've got your TV, which is the traditional TV in a junior suite. It does come out. So I'll show you some of the connections here. The remote control, let me see if it has a source button on it. I don't believe that it does. Here's the remote that's gonna come with the room. If you're looking at bringing a gaming console or something for, you know, the kids to use or to stream movies, make sure that you're bringing a universal remote that will allow you to change the source to the television, because the TVs on the ships, for whatever reason, do not have any buttons on them to be able to change those things. Here is my fridge, and I just noticed the refrigerator door was not fully closed. I never touched it because you all know that I'm not a huge fan of these. I don't think that they really keep things that terribly cold, and use them at your own discretion. You've got a nice little table over here where I keep my mixers and elixirs. You've got a somewhat comfortable chair, though very dated looking. And you're gonna have the glass coffee table. You're gonna have a three-person couch in this room instead of the traditional four-person couch, which it's okay. I haven't really spent much time over there on this sailing, but it's been fine. And then you're gonna have your two nightstands beside of the bed. I did decide to leave my phone on this one, so you see that there is a charger on these white phones for USB-A adapters, which is great for charging your phone at night. It doesn't move really quick, but over the entire evening, it will do wonders. I've started actually moving the phone and putting it down below in the bottom cabinet there section, just to get it out of the way. I found that, you know, I might be knocking some pillows around or, you know, knocking the phone off in the middle of the night. So it's just easier to move it away sometimes. My little buddy over here, I'm not sure what this one's supposed to be, but we've been hanging out some. You've got your full-length mirror here. Hey, everybody. See if I'm even in the frame. And you're gonna have my favorite feature to the Junior Suite, the closet. So it is the only category I know of that has a walk-in closet, and it is always a great size. You see, I have plenty hanging up in here. You're gonna have awesome space over on the left to be able to put things, as well as you're gonna have plenty of space for your suitcases to get them out of the way. You can also put them underneath the bed if you want even more space. So you'll see here on the emergency list where exactly this room is. So it is right there by the midship elevator on deck 9. Moving into the restroom, you'll see that it is a good size. You've got the classic junior suite set up with beautiful granite countersink, and you've got your tub and shower over on the left. As always, make sure that you are stepping up into the shower. This little ledge here is much higher than you think. I've hit my shin on it multiple times, and so I'm trying to save you all from my painful fate. Storage underneath, and you're also gonna have storage in this one behind the mirror. One thing you've heard me talk about that I really like is having space on the kitchen, not the kitchen, the bathroom sink to be able to put some of my items. One funny thing to note, and you know, when you go to different people's houses, I'm sure you all have done this, the toilets sometimes flush a little bit different. So this one, when I go to flush, I've got to remember to hold it for about 3 seconds for it actually to kick in. I can't tell you how many times I've hit the button, walked away, and it only did a partial flush, and I had to come back in and redo that. So just know that if you're in this room, you're gonna have to spend a little bit more time focused on flushing the toilet. Heading outside, one of the beautiful things about this is the Hump balcony is gonna give you amazing views. So you'll see, first of all, this is extra space here. So you've got the curtains, and then you're gonna have, what is that, like 3 or 4 feet of extra space that you're gonna get. You're also gonna have a deeper window over here where there's normally not the space from the curtain to the window, it's normally right there, that you're going to be picking up as well. But if we walk outside, you'll see that the balcony itself is at an angle because it is not the extreme Hump, but it is a little bit smaller. Plenty of chairs out here. If anything, I would say it feels a little bit cramped with the various chairs that they do have out here. And moving around, you have to be a little nimble to find the places to go through. The doors do open up on these, so if you wanted to be able to get in touch with the people beside of you or traveling as a group, you could have the stateroom attendant open that for you. You'll see we are at Coco K today, and so this is what I mean by having a Hump balcony. So you see I am on the outside of the ship. I can see beautiful views when we're sailing, see where we're going. It's really, really nice. And when I look this way, you can see the other Humps, and then it goes back in right on the other side. Wave to Norwegian, everybody. They've actually got 2 ships over there. I think one of them might be a ghost ship right now because it looks like the tender's only running from the one on the right.